Hi children, good morning. Welcome back to our session. So today's our topic is rate of change of velocity. In the previous class we have learnt about the few problems related to the distance and displacement. So today we are going to learn about rate of change of velocity. What do you mean by this rate of change of velocity? If you go for the uniform motion, we have learnt about the uniform motion and non-uniform motion. During the uniform motion of an object along a straight line, the velocity remains constant with time. In this case, the change in velocity of an object of any interval of the time will be the zero. What is that? The velocity will be the zero. But in the case of non-uniform motion, velocity varies with time in different values, different instants and the different points of the path. So the change in velocity of the object during any intervals of the time will not be the same. This is the difference of this uniform motion and non-uniform motion related to its velocity. Then what we have to do? So in this case, we have to introduce one another physical quantity. It is nothing but acceleration. What do you mean by acceleration? Acceleration is nothing but rate of change of velocity. So acceleration is equals to rate of change of velocity. Acceleration is equals to change in velocity by time taken. Acceleration is equals to change in velocity by time taken. Shall we write in symbolic representation of the acceleration? A is equals to V minus U by T. So A is equals to V minus U by T. Here U is equals to initial velocity. Initial is nothing but starting velocity. V is equals to final velocity. T is equals to time. A is equal to acceleration. So A is equal to V minus U by T. A means acceleration, V is final velocity, U is initial velocity and T is time taken. So this is the formula for our acceleration. Then let me see the SI unit for this acceleration. Meter per second square is the SI unit for acceleration. Now let me solve one problem related to this acceleration. Here is our problem. Starting from a stationary position, Rahul pedals his bicycle to attain a velocity of 6 meter per second in 30 seconds. So from the starting, Rahul pedals his bicycle to attain a velocity of 6 meter per second in 30 seconds. Then he applies brakes such that the velocity of the bicycle comes down to 4 meter per second in the next 5 seconds. Calculate the acceleration of the bicycle in both the cases. Let me solve now. Yes. So first, what is given? Let me see. So here we are having the two cases. So in the first case, for us starting from the stationary position, so there the initial velocity what is that? U is equal to 0 meter per second. Then we are having the final velocity. How much final velocity? 6 meter per second. Final velocity V is equals to 6 meter per second. What's the time given for us? 30 seconds. Time T is equals to 30 seconds. What we have to find? Acceleration. We have to find the acceleration. Acceleration A is equals to question mark. A is equal to question mark. Then we have to write the formula. What is the formula, children? A is equal to V minus U by T. A is equal to V minus U by T. So let me substitute the values in this. What's the value of V? 6 meter per second. Then 0 meter per second by what's the time? It's the 30 seconds. So 6 minus 0 is 6. A is equals to 6 by 30. Then what is the acceleration here? 0.2 meter per second square. So A is equals to 0.2 meter per second square. The units are very important, children. We have to mention our units. What's the first case? The acceleration we got 0. A is equals to 0.2 meter per second square. We got the acceleration as 0.2 meter per second square. It is completed? No, we have to go for the second case. Up to here, I think you have understood. Yes, if we go for the second case, yes. So, in the second case, okay. So, in the second case, what is the initial velocity we are having here? U is equal to 6 meter per second. You will get doubt here, I think. Ma'am, this is related for the first case, we are having the 6 meter per second. Yes, in the first case, the starting velocity, it starts from the rest. Rest position means it will be having U is equals to 0. But in the second case, it is the starting point for us. So, the U will be 6 meter per second. Okay? Then, V is equal to 4 meter per second. Then, what's the time given? 5 seconds. T is equals to 5 seconds. A is equals to question mark. A is equal to question mark. What's the formula for us now? What's the formula? A is equal to V minus U by T. Substitute the values, children. What's the value of V? 4 meter per second minus 6 meter per second by the time is 5. So here be careful. If 6 minus 4 means we will write it as 2. But here 4 minus 6 is there. So 4 minus 6 means it's nothing but minus 2. So, minus 2, because the biggest number, we are having it as the minus sign. Minus 2 by 5. What is your answer? What's the value of A here? We are having the A value as minus 0.4 meter per second square. So, this is the second case. So, the acceleration of the bicycle in the first case is 0.2 meter per second square. And in the second case is minus 0.4 meter per second square. Understood, children? Yes. So, by this, let me complete our session. Tomorrow, let me take our new topic. Bye. Thank you.